I'm roasting up a head of cauliflower. Teaspoon of salt, 2 teaspoons of oil, roasting cauliflower for about a half hour on 350 degrees because I'm making white chili today. White cauliflower, white chili. So let's get cooking. We start with about a cup and a half of onions. Ooh, you hear that sound? That's a good sound to make. Now you have to be careful. You don't want any color on the onions because you want to keep this chili white. So I'm going to cook the onions, 1½ cup onions, and 1 red bell pepper, about 1/4 inch diced. The bell pepper is going to be the only color in this chili other than white. Just to give it a little interest, just to give it a little color. I started this with about 2 teaspoons of oil. Then I added the onion, then I added the red pepper. The onions have been cooking for about 10 minutes. No color on these. And it's time to start the seasoning. I'm going to use 2 teaspoons of cumin, ground. I'm going to use 1½ teaspoons of oregano and just a pinch of red chili flakes. They're spicy. So if you don't want any spice, use none. If you want a little spice, use what I use, just a good pinch. If you want more spice, you can add 1 teaspoon or more. I'm also going to add 2 cloves of chopped garlic. I'm going to give that a little stir. Ooh, this is smelling good. Ooh, that's nice. I have here 3 cups of vegetable broth. I'm going to add 1½ cups now. Along with canned chilies. These are canned chilies. There you go. Okay, canned chilies. I'm going to add, they come in 4-ounce cans. I'm going to add 2 cans to it. You can find these in the Mexican food aisle of your local supermarket. Check this out. Ooh, nice cauliflower right from the oven. You want to let this cool off a little bit, then we're going to chop it up. We're going to add it to the chili. We have to thicken up our chili a little bit, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 1 can of white beans and that other 1½ cups of vegetable broth, put it in this little food processor. There we go. I'm going to process it till it's smooth. That is nice and smooth. I'm going to add this to the chili. Look at that. And then I'm going to add another can of beans that I did not puree to the chili. You see, this chili is nice and creamy, but a little bit too loose. So what I want to do now is adjust the consistency with just a little bit of cornmeal. I'm going to use 2 tablespoons of cornmeal. Just sprinkle it right on top and whisk it in. Hey, don't forget about our cauliflower. We've got to chop this up and then add it to chili. That's about how fine you should cut it. okay? And we add the cauliflower right to the chili. Ooh, that's looking good. Now I want all these flavors to come together really nice. So I'm gonna put a lid on it. And I'm going to simmer it slowly for about 20 minutes. And it's gonna be fantastic. This chili is absolutely amazing. Very unique. No tomato, none of that acid, not too much heat, just good chili flavor. Wonderful. If you like this chili, you gotta check out my Cincinnati chili. Absolutely amazing over spaghetti. I'll see you there.